coaster to get here. Can you just bring me back a couple years to you're a four-star recruit coming out of Georgia. How ultimately do you even get to Florida and start this crazy journey?
Going to Florida was a strictly business decision. I was trying, I had a lot of good people in my corner that was telling me, not to fall into the hype into this and that. He was like, go to somewhere where they got good coaches, winning program, great defense. And then, Florida just won out at the end of the day. Got there, got into a little trouble, so I decided to start over, go to Butler, because we had a new coach at the time. And I didn't want to, that was the first thing that he would have thought of me, because that just happened. He just got a job. So I was like, let me just go somewhere else, start fresh, spend a year at Butler. I got second team all conference my year there. That was kind of some, I should have got first team, but I got second team, end up getting, I think 12 offers out of JUCO, not as near as much as, out of high school, but that was expected. But, UAB was just the best choice. I mean, like I said, I don't like losing. So out of all the teams I had, not a lot of them were winning programs. So, and UAB was probably the most winning program, and having Coach Gentry as my position coach, I mean, that just set it over the top. So going to UAB was kind of a no-brainer.
Now, did you have to sell yourself to Coach Clark and Coach Gentry? Were they like, hey man, we're about to take a leap of faith on you. How certain can we be that this is going to work out? Or am I overhyping this? Was it never one of those sit down moments?
Yeah, definitely. I had two former teammates from Butler go to UAB who actually put the word in for me. It was funny because at first they was like, bro, come on, bro. You don't need you. I'm like, bro, I need any looks I can get, bro. I'm looking for opportunity right now. I'm not in high school. These not the same offers. I need anything. And they, put me on UAB. They end up looking at me like me. They offered me when I went down to the official. He was like, look, we don't care about your past, but we want to know, are you going to be your best person when you step foot at UAB? And I told him, yes. I was like, if you give me the opportunity to come to UAB, I will be the best person that I possibly can. I will mature myself to the best person I could be at UAB. And that was it. He took my word for it. He shook my hand. He was like, let's do it. And that was it. We did it.
So I don't want to focus too much on this, but not many people go through what you did. So can you just talk about the mindset, right? Of stuff happens, you get in trouble, you made a mistake. How do you change the way you think about things and what you're doing in order to say, that's never happening again. I'm going to prove myself. I'm going to rebuild. I'm not going to make another mistake. How did you change how you approached, your craft as a football player, but also just becoming an adult and really kind of owning who you want to be?
I just had to, just look in the mirror. After that situation, I had football taken from me because I didn't, I was supposed to play that year. My redshirt freshman year at Florida, I didn't get to play. And that was probably, one of the biggest upsets. I had really, hurt my mom through all that stuff, through all the trauma, whatever, all the stuff that happened. So that and, getting football taken away from me, those are two feelings that I wouldn't wish on anybody. So, that's those two thoughts alone I just keep in my mind every day. So just know that, and throughout the situation, I learned, it's not just me. When I do stuff, it doesn't just affect me, it affects more people. So I don't like hurting people, so I'm going to do the right thing so I can, keep everybody else cool too.
Yeah, for sure.